In this video, I am going to talk about the contributions of laws of learning and its application in the classroom. From the different learning theories we have discussed, it is clear to us learning is of different types and takes places at different levels. Factors like people's intelligence, his previous experience, and content of the subject matter, particularly the topic to be learned, determine the method of learning preferred by the pupils. To choose the most appropriate method for teaching learning process that is suitable for intellectual ability of her learners and the nature of the content to be learned, the teacher should have the broad knowledge of different learning theories as well as their relative merits and demerits. Because no single theory of learning could be considered as the best. Similarly, teacher should also know where to give aim for acquire the knowledge, association, and relation are to be employed. When imitation learning will be highly effective to X, so that he could create the appropriate situation that facilitate the particular type of learning or teaching. In addition to understanding the learning theories, the laws proposed by psychologists also very important for learners to make her teaching learning process effective and highly useful for practical teachers. I am going to explain the laws of learning one by one in the following series. Laws of conditioning. The organism is conditioned to the previous experience. A single trial is enough for conditioning. According to law of continuity, objects have continuity or learn easily because they can easily make a whole. Law of causation. Conditioned stimulus and unconditioned stimulus are associated in time. A conditioned response gets established. Law of discrimination is a selective conditioned response can be established by selective reinforcement. Law of exercise. Frequently, a modified connection between stimulus and response made the connection stronger and the connections will be improved by exercise. Law of effect. Learning occurs only when the respondent has some effect on the environment. Law of extinction. If the reinforcement is not given to the organism previously, established relation between cues is weakened and finally get extinguished. Law of experimental extinction. If conditioned response is elicited without reinforcement by the presentation of unconditioned stimulus, then the conditioned response gets weakened and finally disappears. Law of figure ground. Everything is perceived in the context of its background. Law of frequency. Stimulus and response connections got strengthened depend upon the frequency of repetitions. Law of generalization. All the living organisms generalize the experience and knowledge according one situation to the other situation. According to law of inhibitory conditioning, it means that responses are inhibited when any other response occurs in between the original stimulus and response. Law of posterity. Only last response in the series which was connected to the stimulus was important. Law of practice. Improvement in a performance is possible only if practice is made. Law of pregnancy. According to law of pregnancy, an organism is motivated to learn when there is a tension or disequilibrium of forces in the psychological field. Law of proximity. Near together things are picked up first and learned easily than the distant things. Law of use and disuse. Law of use determines activity on repetitions gets stabilized, strengthened. Law of disuse established says activity not carried for a long time, the power of relationship will decreases. Law of readiness. If anything is imposed on learners, its doing will not be satisfied for him. As a result, he will not be ready for learning. Law of regency. Most recent response is strengthened more by its frequency occurrence than the early response. Law of reinforcement. Any event that changes subsequent behavior when it follows behavior in time. Law of similarity. Individual picks the similar ideas and experience, get easily associated and grasp the things in the learning. Law of spontaneous recovery. If reinforcement is again given, after extinction the previously learned behavior of the organism will return again and his performance would be better than would have been predicted. Apart from the primary laws, there are 5 secondary laws of learning. Law of multiple response. It means when the response fails to elicit a desired effect, the learner will try it with a new response until the goal is reached. Law of mental set. Mental set or positive attitude is very important in any learning process. Law of partial activity. Learner is able to react in the selected way only to the silent elements of the problem and not for the other unimportant things. Law of analogy. According to law of analogy, comparing new situation to the previously learned one and giving a response by analogy is the basics of learning. Law of associate shifting. It means shifting of the response to the new situation which is similar to the earlier one always effective for learning. Students may proceed for further reference. Thank you.